Good morning, class. Again, it's Mr. Lovemore taking you through IT. We are still on the databases and SQLs. Right, yesterday, I can take my slide down. Yesterday, we looked at the select statement, the distinct statement, order by, keyword. We also looked at the where clause. We also looked at the now values, But today we are proceeding with the last part, which is the and, or, and not. If time allows, we also look into the between function and the in. Function, or we can call it operators, is it? But before I proceed, I have to inform you that there's an informal assessment posted on the website, which you have to complete, and then we can revise it tomorrow during our lesson. Please make sure that you complete that informal task, yeah, so that we can revise it together tomorrow. Right, let's go down into today's business. Right, there we go. The and, or, and the not operators. Let's look at what these operators do. Of course, they are used under the where clause, right, the where clause can be combined with and this one, or as well as the not operator. You can use these operators combined, or you can use one of them, two at a time, or depending with the how the person asks you to do. Okay, the and the or operator are used to filter records based on more than one condition. Let's say we've got two conditions, and you want those two conditions to be met, you have to use and. But, or if you want either of the condition to be met, and operator two condition, both condition must be true for it to return the result. Right, then we've got the or operator. The or operator displays a record if any of the conditions separated by or is true. So either one of the condition, if or is true, then it returns true, meaning that the records, either of the records which meet either of the condition, can be returned. But then we also have got the not operator. The not operator. But this operator displays a record if the conditions or a condition is not true, meaning that if it's not true, then the condition, the resource, or the records which doesn't meet that condition will be returned. That is the not operator. But I'm sure you got it, you get it right there, guys. So that's the and, the or, and the not operator. Okay, let's go down and see the syntax, how these operators are implemented in Delphi. Okay, but let's look at the ent syntax first, how the ent syntax is implemented. Okay, we've got our select statement as usual. Select the field, field one, field two, right? From the table name, where condition, this condition, and this condition, and this condition. You can put as many per condition as you can. But we'll look as we move on how to simplify this using the other operator, which we refer to as the in operator. But right, that's how it is implemented. That's the end syntax. Right, let's go and down there and see how the of syntax is implemented. Right, we've got our select statement, select the field name or the field names there from the table name where condition one or condition two or condition three, depending on the number of conditions. Is it? So if either of this condition is met, as we discussed there, it means it returns a true, right? So that's the O syntax, right? Then down there we see the not syntax. It also is a select. You select the fields from the table name where not the condition which mustn't be met. Where not then the condition which you don't want to be retained, or the condition which you don't want to be met. So that's where you put the condition. Remember yesterday we were working with the TBL Movies database. So we are going to try and implement these operators in our program, which we were working together yesterday. But for example, here, let's look at this example. We're having a table with a gender and title and all other information. For example, here is the end operator. We can say, we remember this condition one, condition two, or condition three, depending on the number of conditions. But for example, if I put my where gender is equal to superhero and the score is greater than 10, greater than 8. Right. It means both of these conditions have to be what? To be met. The gender must be superhero and the score must be greater than 80. Right. Let's try to implement this so that you can see how it returns returns the values. Okay, I'll take you back to my Delphi. Let me take you to my Delphi. Right, there we go. Right, I'm going to use it on example one. I'm sure you can see my Delphi program now. Right, so in this case, let's just select everything, select all. Select star, which is all. The same table which we're using yesterday, TBOAT, Morphis. Right. Then where, that's where the condition, where, let's use the first condition. We're looking, the genre must be drama and, the genre must be superhero and the score must be greater than 80. So I'm saying I can put the curly brackets, then I can say China must be equal to, you put double quotes, please, superhero. Superhero. And I have to close there, please, my curly bracket. Then, and. Right. We are saying the score must be greater than 80. Must be greater than 80. I close my curly bracket. So here, we are selecting all the records, all the fields of our records, or all the columns from our TBL Movies. Can I correct my where statement here? From TBL movies, where Jenna is close to superhero and score must be 80. Right. If I run this program, I expect under the Jenna, I'm expecting superhero throughout, and under the score, I'm expecting on all the records with a score greater than 8. Only the records with a Jenna, which is superhero, yeah, then only those records which are greater than 80. So these two conditions must be true. Right, I'm running my program, then I will share the output, the running screen with you so that you can view the output together. So that you can view the output together. There we go. I'm sharing the running screen. Okay, here we've got our screen. But so my code is under example one. If I click there, there is the results. But you can see this column is covers this column. We want all the columns, but we are interested on the Jenna and score. So you see that all the scores are greater than 80 and the Jenna is superhero. So we have managed to achieve what we want there, is it? So that's the end operator. But the next operator, we can try another example. I think we can go to another example whereby we are going to be using the OR operator, okay? But I will switch back to my Delph program. Right. Then, let's go to the next button. But before I take you there, I have to go back to the PowerPoint so that we see what we want to implement, right? So the OR operators next, right? We are saying condition one or condition two, is it? So it's either of those conditions has to be met. Okay, so here we are saying where the Jenna is drama or the Jenna is historical drama. So any record which has got the value of drama under Jenna or the value of historical drama still under Jenna will be retained. So either of those values in our field or either any record with these values will be retained. Okay, let's go and try to implement it and see how it comes out. Right, here we go. For I'm just selecting all the fields, right, from all the fields here with the star. That means all, remember, from our table name, TBL movies, right, where we are saying where the Jenna must be drama. Put this one, Jenna. It's always good advisable to put this curly bracket because each of the condition has to be executed on its own. So we are saying Jenna is close to drama. It's a double course, please don't forget that. Right. Oh, Jenna is close to historical drama. Double quotes, historical drama. I think the drama in small letters, but let me try to extend my screen so that you can all see. So drama, so we are saying select everything from our table, TBL movies, then our condition is genre must be drama or it must be historical drama. So as we have said, any record which has got these values in this field genre will be retained. Right, I'll run the program. Then we see the output together. Here's the form I will share with you. Right, so this is the form. Our code is in assembly 2. Okay, there's a missing SQL property. Let me go and just fix it. Maybe it's one of the termination or which is not there. Let me just quickly go back and fix it. Right, so we are saying select all from TBL movies. Okay, actually I typed my code at the wrong place. This code must be on the top button there. Right. And I'll just copy the code and put it in the rightful place. We are doing it on example 2. Example 2, please. Yeah, right. So I'm just copying the same information there. So in example 2, that's select everything from TBL movies where genre is drama or this, okay? I'll run my program again. Right, I'll share the screen with you, the output screen. Right, if I run there, that's problem here. The query, all right, my spelling for drama there, please forgive me. My spelling for drama is not correct. Right, I have to correct the spelling for drama there. Remember, I left an A there. That's why it's giving me those errors. But anyway, I'm running, then it has to definitely run now. I'm running the program. Then I will share the screen with you, the output screen. Right, then here I go. What's the problem? Screen expression and historical drama, syntax error. Right, syntax error there. Let me just go back and check this error. Okay, let me just go back again. Select LO from TBL movies where, all right, genre is close to drama. Please, it has to be closed there, like what I said. And again, this one, you also open and close. Right, so these conditions must be closed. Not here, but here. You have to close the conditions so that it can work perfectly, okay? Right. Wait there. Closing code. Right. Let's run it again. I will share the screen, the output screen. So it's example 2. There we go. So we've got two records, which has got drama and historical drama values in the field genre. Is it? So these are the two records which we have, which has got these two values. Let's go back and revisit our code again. Right. So select all from TBL movies where Jenna, please open this bracket, say, Jenna scores 2, drama, you close, or Jenna scores 2, historical, drama, you close, is it? Right, these conditions have to be in care brackets, okay? Right. So that's the or. That's the or operator. Right. Now let's go to the next one. In our PowerPoint is the not equal to. No, sorry, not operator, not operator, okay? If you look closely here, it's where not country is equals to United States. So we expect all the other records except for the one with a value of United States. So we are, in other words, excluding United States from our values. Right, if you go back and try to implement it. Right. To go to example 3, come here. Right. So again, we can select, it's not always necessary that you select all, but to simplify things, let's just return all the columns or all the fields. Then we put our condition. Right. Select all from TBL movies again. Right. The way our condition. We said where not it's a country field or country column where country equals to United States. But select all the fields or all the columns from the table name where not is the keyword here. Not meaning that as long as not United States, then it will be retained. The country, as long as not United States, the country will be retained. Right. Let me run the program again and I'll share the output with you. I'll share the output screen with you. Right, there we go. It's example 3. Again, there's an error there. Let me see. Right, let me go back and check what the error could be. That said, not country equal to United States. Where not equals to United States. Right. Let me check here what the error could be. Maybe it could be the country. Where not country. I'm sure my spelling for country is correct there. Right. Where not country equals to United States. United States. So this must return the results. It must return. I don't see anything. Maybe they want us to do this, but I don't see any problem there. Right. I'll run again. Share the output with you. I'll run again and share the output with you. Let me see, it's still giving me an error. Right, not. Okay, let me just take off the curl brackets. Or, okay, sorry, I see. I didn't close the, please. I didn't close the. What an error there. Right. There we go now. It must definitely run. Right. I'll share the output screen again. That's three. Parameter, country, no default value. What it simply means is like I have to type this field as exactly as it appears in the table there in the database. So I think it takes a capital letter C. It's a capital letter C. So I will put a capital letter C there. Then, so we are on this one. Let me take it off. Okay. Right, so a country is the capital letter C. I will run again the project. It's case sensitive. It's case sensitive, right, there we go. Go back to the output screen, which I'm sharing with you. It's example three. Right. Let me just go back and check the value of the country. Our country is spelled. Our country is spelled there. From back from what? From our database. Right. I will check how the country is spelled from everything. Okay. Right. Actually, here I'm selecting from a wrong table. Our table TBL movies doesn't have country. But I'm actually trying to select from a table which doesn't have those fields. So I will just check on the actual table, on the original table. Movies, what it has got another table called. Let me just see. At studios, but it has got another table called studio. So we must be selecting from that table, not the TBL movies. So it must be studio. Okay, this database has got a. Two tables. The first one is TBL movies, then the other one is TBL studios. So that's where I'm supposed to fetch this information, studios. Okay, sorry for that. But if I run this, then I expect my studios tables to display all other countries except for United States. Right, there we go. So we can see that we only have got one country, which is Beijing, which doesn't have the which was not produced from United States. If I can, I may share with you the database, please, so that we can all be at the same level. Let me just show you the database so that we can all be at the same level. Right. Database. Where is the database? So this is the database which we are working with. So it has got these records, two tables. It has got two tables, the movies tables, which has got this information, and the United States, the TBO Studios table, which has got this information. So you can easily see that there's only one record, which is this one, which has got a country which is not United States, as we can see there. So this is the table where I'm fetching my information. Okay. Right. Let's go to the next on PowerPoint. So these are more examples. These are more examples. For example, you can select all the drama and historical data, drama movies using the O operator. You can say select all from TBO movies where genre is close to drama, or genre is close to, we have done this. But you can also do this one. Select all the fields of all movies with a score between 50 and 90, then 50 and 90 must be included. So this will be the code you select, or from TBL movies where the score is greater than or equal to 50, just because 50 is included, and score is less than or equal to 90 because 90 is also included. Right. You can also have this example, all movies that are not superhero and not fantasy or animation movies. But we can have this, select everything from the TBL movies where not genre, but you must put the care brackets there, remember? Not genre is not equals to superhero, close your bracket, and not genre is equals to fantasy. Also put brackets and close, or genre is close to animation, is it? So see, it's the use of and not in the same statement, right? But I'm sure you've understood how the and, the or, and the not operator are used. Okay, let's go to the next item. Right, we also have got some special SQL special operators. But which ones are these special operators? So SQL also uses a few special operators that help to simplify complex conditions. These operators, their functions and their syntax are going to be, I'm going to show you just down there. Right. The in operator, SQL in operator, okay? The in operator allows you to specify multiple values in a where clause. The in operator is a shorthand for multiple ors conditions, is it? If you keep on saying or this, or this, or this, or this, like what I was doing there, of course I used the one with two conditions, is it? So instead of skipping on saying or, we can use the in, okay? This is the syntax, select the field names from the table name where the field name, where you are fetching, you want to fetch the values from or to compare the values from. Field in, then you specify the values which must, which you want to return, is it? Must specify the values for the column or the field which you want them to be met here in this criteria, okay? You've got an example here, a good example, but look at this one. You're selecting all from TBL movies where genre in you specify. So for example, instead of using the and, the or, which we have used previously today, we can use the in. Let's try to implement this one and see, or we can implement the same code. We can implement the same code, the one which we used the or, We can implement it using the in and see how it comes out. But let me just put my share the dev screen there, so that we can try to implement it. But there we go. Where's my Delphi? There it is. Right. So what I'm saying here, I want to implement this same code using the in operator. Okay. We are using implement the same code using the in operator. Okay. So I will just say select, or I will copy. Let me just copy the whole of this part. Right. And this is here. Copying there to just save time. Right. So my way. Where Jenna E. And I open my bracket. Opening my bracket now for the in operator. Right. So it must contain this historical or okay drama. Double quotes. Sorry, no space. Space is a character. Remember, comma. You specify all the items you want, comma, maybe it's a historical drama. Historical drama. Right, so I expect the same result as the one on top there. I have to remember, I have to close the bracket. Right, so I'll run this program and to share the output together. This is example four. It's example four. Right, there we go. So, yeah. So you see that it's returning the same result as this one on top, which is example two, is it? The results are the same, but you see that this one is more simplified than the other one. The results are more simplified, okay? So that's the in operator, used the same way as the or operator, a simplified or operator, okay? But I'll go back and quickly do the, finish up with the next one, which is the between operator, right? So, the between operator selects values within a given range. The values can be numbers, text, or days. Numbers, text, or days. Right. The between operator is inclusive. Begin end values are included, is it? For example, here I'm selecting the field one, field two from TBL, my table name there, where field is between value one and value two. There's an example which I've just attached there. For example, I can select all the fields from the movies, select all from TBL movies, where score between 55 and 65. So it's just, you can alternatively use the and so it's between two values, the lower bound and the upper bound, is it? So that's the between operator, uses the lower bound and the upper bound. So that's how it works. That we can, I'm not sure our time is not on our side. We can even try to implement it quicker. Let's try to implement it quicker. But you can try it. I can give you this as a homework. You try to do this one. Implement it so that you can see how the results are like. Right. In our next lesson, we are going to look at the wildcat operator, the like. Wildcat search operator, like. For example, like. Then we are also going to be looking at, okay, this is the like. We're also going to be looking at how to use deaths when you are selecting from deaths or putting dead conditions. Remember, deaths are used, the condition for deaths is different from strings and integers or real numbers, is it? So we'll look into it. I think it will be a day after tomorrow, because tomorrow we'll be revising that informal task which was posted on our website. Please make sure that you do all the, you answer all the questions, so that tomorrow when you are revising, at least you know where you are lacking and you can correct yourself. But let's end it here for today. Have a good day. Enjoy the rest of the day. Please make sure that you do the task, that informal task. Have a fantastic day. Goodbye.